Slack and HubSpot are both really great tools to use in your workplace, but getting them to work together is even a more powerful combo.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
When Slack's integrated with HubSpot, it'll save you a lot of time by being able to access information inside of Slack without having to go right over to HubSpot. You can also pull information, such as searching for contact information, and get notified of new activity inside of the software. So let's show you how to set up the integration and set some of the notifications inside of Slack. So first, you're going to start inside of your settings area in HubSpot. So you'll go to this area that's called Integrations and Apps. If you already have apps in here, they'll show up, but in this case, we're in our test portal. So I'm going to click on Connect an App. And I'm actually going to do this inside of our portal over at SimpleStrat, because that's going to be a lot easier for us to show on a live portal and a live Slack channel. So I'm going to switch that real quick here. So now that we're inside the integrations area of HubSpot, we're going to click Connect an App, and we're going to go searching for the Slack app. So it's going to give you a lot of apps here. We're just going to focus on this one here today. I'm going to click on View Integration so we can actually connect Slack. So it's going to bring up this dialog box, and it's going to say install Slack for HubSpot, and I'm going to click connect. Now, obviously, you have to be an administrator on your Slack account and your HubSpot account to do this. It's going to ask you about various permissions, similar to any software application would do. We're going to click install. All right, so Slack for HubSpot was connected. So I'm going to go to Slack settings. So this is inside. So now that Slack is connected to HubSpot, this is inside of HubSpot here. It's going to give you the various ways you want this to manifest itself. So we have conversations, and inside conversations right now, that's that chat feature inside of HubSpot. I can choose to sync this. So we've set up a channel in our Slack in advance that was called HubSpot. And so we chose to sync this to HubSpot. But if I go into Slack, you can see that I've got all these channels over here, and this one that is HubSpot is where that is going to go. To set up even different notifications, you have this notification preferences, which again is here in settings, apps, and then you're in the Slack app is how to get to this. So if I click on notification preferences, it'll open up a new window. And then in here is where all of the notification preferences will be about the type of activity that is reported in Slack. So if you go in and check all of these, you will get notifications probably a lot throughout the day, because you get all of these updates in Slack or that'll be happening in HubSpot. So you want to be selective about the type of information that comes into Slack, because if you want people paying attention to it, you want to make sure that it's relevant and important. So there's different sections here. So for example, I can choose to go in and go advanced preferences and look at, okay, there's a new chat conversation on our website. I want to make sure that Slack notifies us of that. That's what all this section is here at the top of the CRM. If you as a user are assigned a company, and right now as I am integrating Slack, it's integrating for me, my personal profile in Slack and my personal profile in HubSpot. So each user needs to go through and do this. In the projects, I can choose, if you use HubSpot projects, I can choose to get notified when I'm assigned a project, so on and so forth. So go through here and find the areas that you want to get notified about and turn those on. So a couple other tricks and tips here with Slack. If you go into the Slack interface itself, and let's say that you've integrated Slack and you want to revoke access. So that can be kind of tricky to find. So I'm going to go to the administrator area here on the drop down of Slack, and I'm going to click on administration and manage apps. So once I get into manage apps here, I've got HubSpot, and I can click on HubSpot. And then once I get into this area here, it's going to tell me here's all the things that you've authorized HubSpot to do in Slack. And if I want to remove the access to this, I simply click remove app. So if I remove app, that'll just undo everything that we just talked about, and you'll have to go in and reset that up again, set up all your notifications again, and so on. So one thing that's a little bit of a trick here is you can go in and add, now that we're integrated, we can go in and add this to HubSpot. So any sort of conversation you have here, I'm just showing you an example on our Slackbot channel, but let's say this is a channel of conversations with a coworker, and the coworker says something like, you know, hey, we need to make sure that, you know, such and such project is added to the notes in HubSpot, or, you know, can you call so-and-so next week? I might want to make that little Slack message into a task and do that really easily inside of Slack. So I can click on these three little drop-down buttons here, and you'll notice here we've got add a task, Or if you're using the service module, we've got add a ticket. So if I click on add a task, it's gonna pop this up here and I can go ahead and add a task title. I can add the details, again, add a due date, add the task type. So I've got this call, email, or to do, and that's how it classifies it in HubSpot. And then I can assign it to myself or I can assign it to someone else, a coworker, and then I would click save and then we go right into HubSpot into the to-dos or an email or a call, depending on how you classified it. So there's a variety of other applications for Slack. You can search for contact information, you can post updates about deals. All of that will show in a future video because there's a lot of cool ways to use it. But for now, you've got the integration set up. Go ahead and set up your notifications and give it a whirl. For more tips, tricks, and how-tos, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you have any comments or questions, drop them below and we'll make sure to address them in a future video.